viernes, el 8 de octubre de mil... No, no, de... eso cuando fue más joven, de 2021. Qué cosa, porque cuando yo vivía en Argentina siempre, 1967, 1963, 66, pero sí, ahora me da cuenta que 2000, it's kind of funny, you know, I just naturally, it's funny because I'm so in the habit of saying 19 something. Well, the rain's coming, the storm isn't coming, it's upon us. Fall, but winter's coming soon. It's I've seen some snow up higher. So, you know, I was thinking about things, and I think maybe I'll do my videos in two languages, a couple of them. So this one, puede ser en español o castellano, and I'm also going to do it in English. So here we go. That looks like that's funny. Pero es tranquilo aquí ahora. Pero mundialmente no es tranquilo. Y el borde de nuestro país no es tranquilo. You know, it might seem calm here, but it's not calm all over the world. It's not calm on our border. And let's talk about Juan Osaven, okay? I watched him today on Rachel Ham over on BitChute, and it was, Juan is a tremendously intelligent, but tremendously good man, and he does his best to explain it to people what's going on. And frankly, it is complicated business. And so when I listen to Juan, especially on a message like this, I shut out everything else and I listened to him straight. It was like an hour with Rachel Ham, but it was excellent. Así que Juan Osaven, cuando él habla, está hablando profundamente de cosas muy, muy importantes. Así que yo paro lo que estoy haciendo y escuché a Juan intentamente para comprender lo que está diciendo, porque son cosas complicadas, pero importantísimos a la vez. Cosas que afectan todo el mundo. Estamos en una lucha espiritual. We're in a spiritual struggle. Y a veces pienso que la gente norteamericana están dormidas. No saben lo que está pasando generalmente. No saben quién es presidente, no entienden la diferencia de quién está controlando el militar y quién está controlando las otras cosas. People don't understand the difference of who's controlling what. Pero también estaba, aunque okay, I'll try to, it's, las cosas son graves ahora, okay? Y Juan se anima. Things are grave right now. Juan gets pretty excited and I don't blame him. Life or death situation. Complicated business. And I was thinking, you know, we need, you know, the white people haven't been here that long, really. You know, they came out here and this used to belong to Mexico, right? And before the Spanish conquistadores came over here, it belonged to the indigenous people, which are the tribe of Joseph. That's a whole nother subject. And, people just don't, they don't want to know. They don't want to know the truth, okay? No quieren saber la verdad. They don't want to know the truth. They don't want to know it. They fly to pieces if you just like go out of bounds a tiny bit of what's correct in their mind, okay? So, de vuelta al mensaje. Quizás la gente que habla en español o castellano tienen corazones que pueden entender la verdad mejor. Yo pienso que puede ser así. La gente indígena, la gente que habla en español, que muchos de ellos son más puros que los de los norteamericanos. Y la gente aquí que nunca han vivido en Argentina, o Chile, o Guatemala, o Honduras, o México, o San El Salvador, o Costa Rica, no saben, o Brasil, no saben lo que pasa.
People that haven't lived, you know, in Argentina, or Brazil, or Ecuador, or Honduras, or Guatemala, they don't, you know, they don't know. They take things for granted. They haven't seen kids that don't have shoes, or just have a shirt until they're 5 years old. They play soccer with a cantaloupe, or whatever they can put together, okay? I've seen it. I've seen, you know, no running water. You go to the well, you go to the river, you wash your clothes in the river, you poop somewhere. Millions of people live like that. And then you come back to this country and you see a house with 3 bedrooms, you're like, wow, man, 40 people would live in that house comfortably.
La gente aquí sí no saben lo que es pobreza. No saben. No saben qué es lavar la ropa en el río, sacar el agua del pozo del río, tener un pozo negro. No saben. Tienen muchas cosas. Tienen coches, they got toys, they got RVs, they got motorcycles, they got beautiful Jeeps, they got all kinds of stuff. So, I was thinking, maybe I'll meet Nino Rodriguez
in Las Vegas soon. I think I'm going down to Las Vegas next weekend. Going down to Las Vegas. But I was thinking, you know, Juan wants to get the message out, obviously, but it's difficult. Because people, they don't want to know the truth. They don't comprehend the truth. You know, I don't know all the stuff that's going on militarily. Of course, I'm not a military person. But I try to understand what's going on. I'm a civilian. But the military is very active. Yo no soy un milico, como dicen en Argentina. I'm just a regular citizen, okay? But I'm glad I'm not
in a conflict zone, but my heart goes out to people in conflict zones. Look at that. The storm is upon us. Viene el invierno y va a ser un invierno duro. Sí, tenemos el sol de vez en cuando, pero hay una lucha espiritual, una lucha muy, 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 muy intensa, espiritual. Y mucha de la gente aquí no se dan cuenta. Todo está piola, todo está tranquilo. Estoy hablando de los Estados Unidos, ¿eh? Pero esta parte, porque hay partes que no está tranquilo.
Que no está tranquilo. Así que quizás voy a hablar con Juan. Y quizás hacemos, pienso, Nino Rodriguez, Nino Rodriguez, campeón de boxeo, 7 veces. Maybe I'll get to meet Nino Rodriguez because, you know, I could translate for Juan to a certain extent. You know, my vocabulary is not perfect in translation. But I'm sure that Nino habla español. I don't think Juan does. Ya sé que 48 no lo habla. Pero
más gente tiene la meta es para más gente saber lo que está haciendo. Y Juan, it makes me laugh when he calls Juan Juanito. It's just kind of funny. Anyway, God bless Juan Osaven because he communicates the message. And he does it by choice, just like other people sacrifice. They're ready to sacrifice everything, their fortune, their sacred honor, even their lives to do the truth, just like the founding fathers. Makes me kind of think of San Martin because he was a libertador de Argentina y Bolivia y otros países en Sudamérica.
Así que voy a hablar en español también, porque la gente quizás son más inteligente que muchos de los norteamericanos, que no aprecian la vida que tienen. Muchos no lo aprecian. Solamente tengo eso, solamente tengo eso, no tengo esto. Bueno, vete a Argentina. Otro país, muchos países, no tienen lo que nosotros tenemos. Así que Dios, quizás Dios tiene que sacar lo que tenemos para que nosotros somos muchos más humildes y sabemos lo que tenemos. Porque esta es una lucha espiritual
para todo el mundo, no solamente este país. Si cae este país, estamos podridos, reventados, terminados. Pero Dios va a ganar, pero todavía... Sí, gente dice, God's won, God's won. Yeah, he wins in the end, but it's up to you.
I was going to film this in Spanish, fork. Tenedor español. You know? Because we are at a fork in the road. Juan said, choose a lane. Escoge. But it's not sitting on your bum and watching Fox News. That's like una locura total. So, Friday night, I need to post this. Yeah, we all got to be in the battle. I'm doing what I can, okay? Pero quizá voy a hablar más con la gente que habla español. Porque los norteamericanos están total... Muchos son dormidos. No saben lo que pasa. No quieren saber. A lo mejor esta noche están divirtiendo o... Y la gente que me está mirando fútbol norteamericano o NBA. ¡Qué porquería total! ¿Por qué no estudian? ¿Por qué no saben lo que está pasando?
Yeah, you're gonna watch football and NBA stuff? You gotta be kidding me. You gotta be kidding me. I can't even watch it for 3 seconds. Well, yeah, that's a good view. There's rays of light. Beautiful. It's a spiritual war, folks. Gotta be involved right now. Right now. No matter, you know. Of course, most of us don't talk to our familias, right? Because they don't want to know. They don't want to know. They don't want to know. They choose not to know. Thanks for this beautiful earth, planet, and Heavenly Father. Que Dios bendiga a los que están sufriendo. Y como dice Juan, esto es para los niños, para los chiquititos. Esas cosas, esas macanas,
esas cosas malas están sucediendo con los niños ahora mismo. No está terminado, pero tiene que estar terminado. Y cuando un niño está dañando o no anda bien, hay que luchar. Yo tengo que luchar mucho, mucho más. Mucho más. Anyway, looks like I'll be in Las Vegas next weekend. Thanks to supporters and things. I'm going to go down there. So I'll be in Las Vegas next weekend and should have a get-together, but it's going to be La Lucha Espiritual Continue. There's an event down there, and I'm going to attend it. You betcha I'm going to attend it. Look at the beautiful sun coming out, okay? Look at that. That's a message. Okay, I'll end it. Right here with this beautiful message, or beautiful thing. I'm trying to do a good message. God bless the world. God bless those in the spiritual fight. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.